Hey everybody, welcome back to The Long Dark. My name is Bear. Before I even get into it today, I kind of want to make a note of the fact that this is just going to sound like showboating for showboating's sake, but I really like how quickly your game loads in this. It's like a 5-second load from the menu screen. It's beautiful. I don't think it was like that all the time. I'm pretty sure... Ooh, nice, a down ski jacket. I'm pretty sure that was an improvement they made in one of the recent updates, so... Good on you, Hinterland! It's looking good, man. We found ourselves a nice little cabin to try to make use of here. We got plenty of drawers to search, plenty of cabinets to loot out. Hopefully we'll find, a nice fleece sweater as well. We got a lot of clothing, so I'm gonna probably try to go through my inventory pretty soon here to see what the best loadout is gonna be. Another fleece sweater, my god. That's fantastic. More drawers over here as well. Gonna go through the loadout, probably try to harvest quite a few of these new clothing items to get some cloth. Get some leather perhaps as well if we were to be lucky enough to find leather fitted items to be wearing or using rather. I am trying to use a lot of matches to be able to get myself this good old light source. And yes, I realize now that it is probably water taken out of the back of the toilet as opposed to down here. I recognize that now. That makes quite a bit more sense. It makes me feel a bit safer about drinking the drinking the toilet water. Ooh, there's a medicine shelf here as well, nice. With nothing. Alright, well, pretty good so far, not bad results. I'm gonna keep scavenging this entire area. Still need to find, like, a can opener or something. I recognize that, yeah, of course, I could still try to smash those things open, but much rather have the...
Looks like this has been here a while.
Have the option of opening them properly. A thin wool sweater as well. So yeah, lots and lots of clothing. Unfortunately, not too much by way of food. So let's go on down into the kitchen and maybe see if we can fix up that particular dilemma. We've already searched through this drawer, apparently. I think we've searched a bit through the downstairs. The kitchen, though, I believe still has a few areas left for us to scavenge about. And I guess I shouldn't be so surprised. Ooh, nice. There's venison in the freezer. Maybe we should keep that in there, actually. Let's go ahead and put that back. I imagine keeping that in the freezer and keeping the freezer shut may be a good idea. I kind of want to try to employ that strategy. Oh, wow, we're getting some weird slowdown here. This is interesting. Hold on a second, let me see if I can figure out why that is. There we go. Okay. All fixed. I think my Windows is being bonkers. But, nonetheless... Yeah, I'm gonna try to keep the, nice, more matches. Keep the venison in the freezer for now. Maybe we'll be able to use that later on. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to really start any kind of fire inside of this house. Although, if I do want to venture across the lake, it might be in my best interest. Ooh, wow. Cooked rabbit. Okay. Don't tell Wife Taffy. I may want to take as much as I possibly can with me on that voyage. Pork and beans as well. So yeah, we're getting plenty of food from this area. Soon as I search through all this stuff, I'm probably gonna go on a bit of a an inventory clean-out spree. See what the best stuff is that I can keep with me for the ride. And see what we need to harvest and or maybe dump off in here. Because this probably isn't a bad place to try to come back to, try to call home. Even though I'm pretty sure, as I mentioned before, there's not really anywhere I can start a fire in here. But the fire may not be as big of an issue as I think. If I can manage to start a fire outside or something like that, or maybe there's a fireplace actually, I should check that out before I start hypothesizing on how I'll actually handle that problem.
Looks like this has been here a while.
Some pinnacle peaches as well. Okay, it looks like we're almost done searching through this place. We have searched the oven. Just one more match to make sure I'm not missing out on anything on the countertops or anything like that. It doesn't look like I am. I'm colder as I kneel. That's interesting. I think there's another cabinet door maybe upstairs that I didn't check out. I think I might have done both, though. Alright, so that is basically that. This entire area is cleaned out. Let's have a quick look at the inventory here. Our hunger and thirst is good. It is only 3:40 in the afternoon, so we got plenty of time to go out and see what else we can find. Clothing-wise, we have 3 fleece sweaters, and I don't know if I can wear one without... okay, so you take off the thin wool sweater to replace that with a fleece sweater. Fleece sweaters, unfortunately, aren't that great. In fact, the thin wool sweater is probably better, so we probably want to put this on and then harvest a bunch of these fleece sweaters in order to be able to improve our other things here. So let's go ahead and grab these. Harvest the 69% fleece sweater. I know how much of a cardinal sin that is against our people, but it's gotta be done. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I don't really want these anymore. The thin wool sweaters, oddly enough, are providing me a much better warmth benefit, so I don't really want to carry these fleece sweaters around, knowing that they're just going to be dead weight, basically, and they could turn into cloth to make the existing sweaters a little bit better. So that's going to do that. I'm going to harvest one pair of these wool socks and probably use it to repair the other one. Throw those on as well. And what else have we got? We have a few toques. I need to be wearing the better percentage toque, so let's go ahead and harvest this one and maybe even harvest the second one, too. Probably for the best. Am I wearing... Yeah, I'm wearing bad wool socks as well, so I'm just going to harvest the low percentage gear to make sure that I'm switching over to the better stuff as soon as I can. Okay, that'll do, and I can also harvest this thin wool sweater because I need to improve the other one with that, too. We have a sewing kit, so we're going to be able to do this. In fact, I think we have multiple sewing kits, so that's going to be nice. Let's make sure I'm wearing all the good stuff now. Let's throw on this toque here, get the better condition one, make sure. Actually, let's go ahead and sort by condition. That way we know what we're doing here. We're going to wear that. We're going to wear... actually, I bet the wool is probably better. Indeed, it is. I'm going to throw on these wool socks as well as this... actually, I think that might just about be it. Let's see if I can. So I switched that off, and that is a lot better than the insulated vest, so I suppose I should probably keep doing that. Let's go ahead and repair a little bit, and then we'll probably have to get the hunger and thirst issues taken care of pretty soon here. Down ski jacket should be a pretty awesome wearable item here. It shall suffice our needs for over-the-torso clothing. These repairs are going to take a lot longer than I initially expected, so we're probably going to end up spending the night here trying to eat and drink some of the food and stuff we got. Yeah, we are dehydrated now already, so we got to take care of that. Let's do... maybe... well, we don't have any leather to repair the basic boots, so I guess we're not going to be taking care of that right now. Let's see if I can drink any of this water I've got. I've sorted by condition here, so obviously we're going to do that. This is all safe to drink. Oh, nice. So we have 7 liters of drinkable water. That's actually really good. And the tin of sardines somehow takes care of my thirst a little bit. That's interesting. We don't have pinnacle peaches. I'm not really that hungry. I don't necessarily need to eat anything, but I could have an orange soda real fast. Or I could just drink this. It's probably a better option. It may not be too late to go out and scavenge or go out and try to find another area, although we're probably better off just sticking around here trying to maybe repair and harvest a few more things and then spending the night inside of this area. I just want to make sure. This looks like a door to a basement, but I guess it's not accessible at the moment. I suppose we're not meant to go down there just yet. We'll pop on the tube, see what we can check out. Old adventures, man. On the TV, that would take away from my stress levels hanging out in here. I want to watch the wild thornberries. They know what to do. Smashing! Let's see. Okay, so I'm going to harvest a little bit more. Actually, maybe repair a little bit more. Let's see what I can do. I can fix up our basic gloves a little bit, and that would bring those up to 100%, which is probably a good use of our time. I'm going to try to get down to, like, 10 o'clock at night before I call it a day here. I'm going to harvest these wool socks as well. We are already wearing socks, so we don't need to worry about that. If I have something that I can harvest for leather, I definitely want to do so, but I don't know if I'm going to have that option at the moment. Doesn't really look like it. What can we turn cloth? Oh, we can harvest cloth for bandages now. That's interesting. And we can turn newsprint into tinder plugs as well. A newsprint roll turns into 4 of them. Maybe we should do that. That only takes like 7 minutes, too. Nice. Tinder plug out of the inventory. That's good. All right. Our fatigue is not even really that bad, so if I wanted to, I could try to venture out at night, but that doesn't really seem like the greatest idea in the world. Let's try to harvest just a bit more of the stuff that we definitely don't need. Basic gloves we're already wearing, so we obviously want to harvest those for the cloth. And then we'll probably move on to that second or third toque, and then we'll probably be done here for the remainder of the day. Actually, the mittens are probably going to be the last thing we do. It is 10 o'clock now. Nearly 10 o'clock. I could go ahead and call it a night. I could also forge for wood. Forging for wood may not be that bad of an idea. Because we would, oh, actually, yeah, we can get for, oh, right, now, this is a new thing. We can decide upon what we want to forage for, in the areas that we're in. So that's really nice. So instead of just trying to randomly hope that you get what you need, you can now decide to either forage for tinder or forage for, wood. So I'm going to go ahead and get some reclaimed wood from this area. And we don't have any tools to use, unfortunately, so we're just going to go ahead and spend an hour doing this. Seems like a pretty good use of the time we have left down here. And then it's going to give us a bit more fatigue as well. So we'll probably just try to go to sleep right after that. Let's see where we're at in the house right now. There we go. All right, this is good. Let's go ahead and sleep through to about 6 a.m. That'll burn a few calories here. We should probably just eat and drink and then be on our way as soon as we arise here. This is a pretty good situation here. Nearly through the first full day of survival. Need to eat and drink quite a bit. Don't necessarily want to eat the canned stuff yet, but we will have granola bars and energy bars to get us through the day, as well as that delicious toilet water to get us on our way. All right, condition's still pretty good for a lot of our stuff. We have plenty of water to go out in a boot, so let's do it. I think I'm ready. I can go for a bit more to eat, but I think I'll be okay. Let's venture out into the great outdoors once more. I think I'm gonna try to cross the lake. I'm tempted to make that happen. Ooh, that is beautiful. The beautiful sunrise of the coastal highway. So, our options here. That is, of course, the other island that contains the other cabin. I could try to venture out that way. Oh, God, that was bad. Ooh, whoops. That was a big mistake. Sprained ankle. Oh, crap. I should be paying more attention, man. All right, I need to take painkillers and rest for 4 hours, which is probably a good idea anyway. Oh, that was dumb. That was really stupid. And there's the painkillers. Oh, never mind. Sprained ankle healed. All right, that was easy enough. Good. Now let's not fall off of cliffs anymore. Okay. Excellent. So I could try to walk out that direction, but honestly, it's kind of terrifying, and I think I'd rather go for this island over here. We've been having a lot of good luck going toward the islands, so maybe I should go ahead and keep trying to cash in on that value. I'm also kind of terrified of this ice right now, considering, well, we went through the Spookathon and the Penumbra game contained a weak ice. Oh boy. Yes, it contained cracking ice, and this is starting to make me feel like, yeah, that's exactly what prevents us from getting out that far. Oh God. Oh God. Oh God, get back. Get back. Oh jeez. Okay. I realize now. That is the measure they have taken to prevent you from going that way. Ooh, that was scary, man. That crackling sound. I'm pretty sure that's almost guaranteed death if you wait around too long on that. So that's probably how it stops you from going that far. Is it, you know, kills you. in a certain way, it does stop your life right in its tracks. The waterfront cottages. Alright, we may find some goodies here as well. Very, very nice. Let's head inside. I'm trying to find can openers still. Of course, this has been our goal from the onset, I guess.
I could use this.
Another water bottle is very nice as well. Hopefully, maybe find some new items, too. We've already found a couple of new things. We're getting a lot of water, which is nice, I guess. Especially, wow, God, yeah. This is maybe the most water I've ever had playing The Long Dark. This is fantastic. Still pretty damn dark inside of these areas. Suppose there's the matches for that very purpose. It's been giving us quite a few matches. Ooh, shoes, nice. I can harvest that for leather and improve my basic boots. Very, very good. We'll go ahead and light another match here, I guess, just to help us out. Still no can opener that I can see. Just trying to look on all the shelves. Hoping that one will show up at some point. Oh, nice. There it is. Right on cue. Beautiful. Finally got that coveted can opener. I did leave food in the freezer in the other cabin. I got to realize that. Ooh, nice. Another bit of cooked meat there as well. Pinnacle peaches, and let's find out what's in the freezer here. Oh, raw. Okay, raw stuff. That is... Maybe I should leave that in the freezer, actually. I am going to... you know what? I'm going to leave it in there. I don't think I necessarily want to have the raw stuff. That would be a bit too much to... It's basically, I'm getting a chore from the freezer at that point. Alright, might as well search through all these cabins while I'm in here. All these cottages, man, they have quite a few searchable areas. I think that's maybe one of the big differences between Mystery Lake and the Coastal Highways, that the homesteads, the cabins, the cottages and all that, they have quite a few more cabinets, you know, drawers, dressers, ovens, fridges to search through. I'm surprised, actually, like, with the camp office and all that stuff back in the Mystery Lake, they didn't have anything like a refrigerator, which they have now, of course. Refrigerator kind of seems like something that you would need being out in this place, but... then again, like I tried to do, maybe what they, did usually was, you know, try to just keep all their food out in the snow, which would certainly save on power. That's a perfectly viable alternative, actually, now that I think about it. Maybe something I should consider doing, considering how frickin' freezing it's gonna get soon here. Utah just has the complete polarization of temperatures, man. We get anything from -6 degrees to 106 degrees. It's ridiculous. It's absolutely absurd. But it's also kind of pretty here, so... Suppose we take trade-offs where we can get them. Although there's not many. let's see what else we can get up here. This is basically the exact same house as the other one, so we're just kind of going through the motions here, searching for what we can. We got that can opener, which is really, really good. A very, very nice find in this house. And we're probably going to get some more toilet water here, too, actually. Search through the last little bit of dresser drawers here. We are encumbered now, unfortunately, so I should probably go ahead and try to use that can opener to open up a few of these cans and maybe, a ski jacket. Damn. We have to see if that's better than my currently done insulated thing. Cotton long underwear, that's probably going to turn into cloth for me here. Nothing on the dresser or the armoire over here, rather. That is one more drawer to search over this way. Light a couple more matches to make sure we're... Ooh, nice, another down vest. Make sure we're seeing everything here. Does this place have a bathroom? I hope so. I think I walked by it on the other side. Oh, man. Lots of searching. Lots of searching to be done today, but we gotta take advantage of everything we possibly can here. Can't leave... No mitten left behind. No fleece sweater left behind. That's the Long Dark initiative, man. Cargo pants as well. Jeez, alright. Maybe those will turn into... Nah, those will turn into cloth. I was gonna be hopeful that those would maybe turn into leather, but that would not make any sense. Alright, take it all. Oh, boy. Alright. Another medicine cabinet? Indeed there is. Another point, or 1.57 liters of drinkable water in the inventory, and we're gonna probably try to eat quite a few of the goods we've got now and take care of our encumbrance issue. So let's use that can opener to full effect, try to eat all the canned goods. That's gonna take a lot out of our inventory, actually. That's gonna be a good weight off of our shoulders. Suppose it takes a little bit of time to open up all these cans, though. Alright, Pinnacle Peaches, that's gonna be another 0.5. I kinda wanna smash open a couple cans just to see what happens here. Especially considering I really could, stand to drop off a couple more kilos. So, let's try it out. Try it out with the Pinnacle Peaches and see how effective this is. Sounds like he is scraping it on the floor just like we kind of expected. 15% was lost. Okay, so it's really not that bad. Not that bad of a loss from the, smashed open. Okay, good. From the typical amount, so I suppose we could have been doing that for a little while. So the insulated vest is not going to be as good as everything else we've got. Let's go ahead and harvest this. We've only spent 2 hours of this day moving around so far, so this is good. Lots of leather from these shoes as well. That's going to be very nice. We're going to spend a little bit of time repairing my basic boots now that we've got a bit of leather here. Let's go ahead and do that. Repair my basic boots right there. Use the leather. The sewing kit's got a pretty damn high percent chance of being successful. And we'll do it one more time, just to get it up to a really solid position there. Very, very nice. Okay, and let's just check out on everything else here. Don't have the toolkit to repair the storm lantern, unfortunately. That's weird that that has a condition now. That's kind of interesting. I'm wearing jeans. I feel like I could be wearing something a lot better than jeans right now. Let's see if there's, we've got cargo pants to give me those benefits. Yeah, those are a little bit better, so let's go ahead and wear those. Then we'll probably use, might even harvest the jeans, to be honest. Might do us better as a source of cloth than anything else. Gonna harvest the basic wool hat as well. Actually, ooh, that might have been a mistake. I think the basic wool hat might have been better than the toque, I'm not sure. That could have been an error. I'm gonna try to dump off quite a bit more of this, inventory space, though. Let's check on the ski jacket. Let's see if that's a bit better than what we've got going on right now. I suspect it might be. That gives us a degree and a half of warmth, and we are currently wearing the down ski jacket, which is quite a bit better, actually. Okay, so we don't want to do that. We're going to repair the down ski jacket as often as we can, actually. Let's go ahead and let's try to do that now. Let's see what kind of percentage we can look at. That is 22%. That would be fully repaired. Let's go ahead and do that. Take a little bit of cloth out. This is good. We're getting further down on the over-encumbrance issue. The heaviest stuff, though, let's have a look and see, sort by weight. See what we can get rid of. It's mostly the water, so if we keep drinking this away, obviously that's going to help, but that's going to be something we'll want to keep in the inventory as well, of course. The bedroll is kind of heavy. The cooked... Ooh, yeah, okay, so you know what? We could eat this, but unfortunately we're not really that hungry. Antiseptic is pretty heavy. This, yeah, oh, man. All right. If we harvest this stuff, because we don't need two pairs of cotton long underwear. Actually, do we need to wear one of these? Let's see. Let's start by the clothing condition here. Do we need to wear cotton long underwear as opposed to something else? We got wool long underwear that we're wearing right now, so I think we just need to harvest both of these, and hopefully that'll be closer and closer to that over-encumbrance problem solved. So let's go ahead and harvest this, and then harvest the next cotton long underwear. We've already spent like a good 4 or 5 hours in here trying to harvest and repair stuff. We'll harvest the ski jacket as well for two sources of cloth. I'm pretty sure the cloth is a lot lighter than the clothing items that they come from, so that should be worthwhile. One more source of cloth from there, and then we might just take a nap, considering how fatigued we probably are from all this stuff we're doing. Alright, we're finally not encumbered anymore. We got a lot of cloth to use, and this is going to do it for this episode of The Long Dark, guys. Lots of harvesting, lots of repairs, and lots of scavenging, but we're in a really good spot right now with the resources we've got, so looking forward to the next few days. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.